At his press conference earlier today, Jagdeo spoke of the thousands of foreigners who are arriving in the country and little evidence to show that they are leaving. In fact, recent reports show some 8,000 Haitians alone arrived in Guyana so far this year and less than half left. Government has been contending that these persons are just using Guyana as a transit point to move on to other countries.
It seems from the analyses which have been made available to the government that many Haitians are heading for a third destination, that they're not interested in staying here and they may want to go to a third country. Again, these are all allegations, but as far as we are concerned, we want to protect the sovereignty and integrity of Guyana. We don't want to be used as a conduit for illegal migration.
But the opposition leaders say this is a matter for concern.
Our problem is not just Haitians, though, because there are others. People are being exploited. They have to pay to come through here. And they're then smuggled out of Guyana in an organized fashion. And no sensible Guyanese would think otherwise. From how you see the operations at the airport, they're met there, they're chaperoned, taken with bus, then go moving to the border, overnighting around the place, etc. That this, I pointed out, that at $5,000 and 8,000 came in, over 8,000 so far, that's $40 million. People smuggling.
According to the opposition leader, the government seems to be turning a blind eye to the issue.
Which president or a minister will not be concerned that if your country is being used with gangs to smuggle people out, 8,000 people in 7 months of the year, that it's not a concern of yours how porous your borders are? Because if people can go that way, people can come in, they can bring in guns, they can bring in drugs, they can take out guns or whatever. You must be concerned about the porosity of your borders. And not just with Venezuela, with Haitians, but with any other group, Colombians, Venezuelans, whatever. Because this just shows that you don't care. So I don't care that they come here and they disappear. Because that's not our problem. But that is coming into your country and then being smuggled out of your country. Which government behaves this way?
Reporting for Earth Evening News, Vanu Manikchand.